Images have now come to Bard, and this is just one new Bard feature. Ooh, this is gonna be big. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custodi, and I make enough Google content to fill a hockey rink. But today is all about the new Google Bard updates. So, what's new in Google Bard? A whole lot, starting with Bard being available in over 40 new languages. So since May, Bard has been available in English, Japanese, and Korean across, I think, 180 countries and territories. Well, now Bard has finally expanded to include a whack of new languages, from German to Arabic and many in between. Plus, access to Bard has expanded to include all 27 countries in the European Union and Brazil. And by the way, as we go through these Google Bard updates and you're back at the beginning wondering, what is Google Bard? I encourage you to go watch my other video on that and then come back here so we can actually jump into these new updates. Next, Bard has more precise location settings that you should notice when you sign in. So when you give Bard access to your precise location, you're going to get more relevant responses about restaurants and things in your area. You'll have your location in the bottom left where you can click to update your location if necessary. So this is really helpful if you're traveling and you want to make a plan for dinner or activities near you. So you can just ask Bard, what's the best Italian restaurant near me? Rather than having to type in your city or location, and Bard will pull up results with the highest Google ratings. And you may notice something new in these results. Yes, images are now available in Bard, but you'll have to wait a little bit longer to find out all the awesomeness with images in Bard. The third update you should know about is that Bard can now read responses out loud. I love me an accessibility update. This text-to-speech capability in Bard is currently available in over 40 languages, including Hindi, Spanish, and English. So in your chat, just click on the speaker icon and your response will be read aloud to you.
Here are some of the best Italian restaurants near Scottsdale, Arizona, according to Google reviews.
Moving on, you can now activate dark theme in Bard. So many people had been asking for this. From Bard, click on the settings gear near the top right and choose dark theme. This instantly turns the background dark with light text, making it easier on your eyes in dim light. And then you'll just click on that settings gear icon again to change it back to the light theme if you prefer. And there are also new ways to modify Bard's responses. Here's what I mean. There are now 5 new options to help you modify Bard's responses. So let's try this with a prompt and see what response we get. I'm gonna ask Bard to write an email newsletter promoting my podcast called Talk Techie to Me. I'm gonna give a few more details here and then see what I get. Okay, so let's say I want to modify this response. At the bottom of the response, I'll click on the Modify Response button. Here I can choose between making the response shorter, longer, simpler, more casual, or more professional. Just click on one of the options to have that response generated in that style. It just makes it that much easier to get a response more in the tone that you're looking for. Now keep in mind, when you do this, it replaces that first version. But don't worry, I will show you how to recall that later on. But for now, if you did like parts of that first version, maybe you'd want to copy it out first. All right, now let's talk about some exciting new export features. You can now export to Google Docs, Gmail, and Google Sheets. This is so good. Do I keep saying that about all these features? Well, what are you gonna do? If it's good, it's good. So let's start with Docs and Gmail. From a response, we'll click on the share button in the bottom. Here, as a side note, you can share your response, which by the way, creates a public link to share, which is pretty cool. So that's how to share Bard conversations. But back to what we were actually talking about, if you click on that share button, you can export to Docs or as a draft in Gmail. All you have to do is click the option you want. So if we click the export to Docs, a doc is automatically created. Simply click to open that doc in the bottom left of Bard. Here, a new tab opens up, keeping that same formatting we had in Bard. Now, I would obviously recommend renaming it, but How easy is this? I love it. So now, as promised, we can do the same thing with Bard and Google Sheets. This obviously only works when you create a table inside Bard. So let's have Bard generate a table for me, comparing all the NHL teams, Stanley Cup wins, organized per year from most wins to least wins. Instantly, a table is created for me. And if we scroll to the bottom of that table, there's a handy little export to Sheets option. All we have to do is click on that option to export this table with the formatting right into Google Sheets. This is done the same way as with Docs and Gmail, so let's click to open our new spreadsheet in a new tab. How cool is this? I freaking love it. Now, there's an update that a few of you eagle-eyed viewers may have already noticed. You can now pin threads, create new chats, and pick up where you left off in recent chats. Yes, finally. So here's what this looks like now. If you remember from when Bard was first released, it did not have the ability to create new chats. So everything you prompted about any topic was all lumped together in one chat. Well, not anymore. So you can finally create new chats in Bard. So if we don't want to muddy up this thread with something unrelated, we will just create a new chat. Just click on new chat in the upper left corner, and a new chat is created for you from scratch, where you can talk about any topic you want. So we can finally stay organized per topic in Bard. Plus, you now have a list of your recent threads on the left-hand side as well. So you can hover over a recent chat and click the three-dot menu icon in order to rename the chat. I recommend doing this so that you can stay super organized. And you can just click on a chat, by the way, to open it back up and jump back in where you left off. But you can also pin a thread from the left-hand menu too. So if you know one of these is most important, just go ahead and pin that to the top of your recent chats using that three-dot menu icon. Now with this, I want to talk a little bit about your chat history here too. It used to be that Bard just kept your prompts for you and that's all. Well, check this out. If you click on the Bard activity option near the top right, a new tab will open up for you with your chat history. Before, only your queries were saved, not the responses generated, which was very annoying. But now, even though it looks like just your queries are here, it's actually got the responses saved in the details. So you can click where it says Bard on the query or where it says details. And this will open up a pop-up with the responses generated as well. And by the way, in this example of my email newsletter we had written in a simpler way, it shows both of the results. So this is how you'd find that earlier version if you had rewritten something in a different tone and it replaced that original response. Amen. And I might have saved one of the best updates for last. That's right, images are now available in Bard, which you may have noticed with a couple of our examples. But let's dive a little more into Google Lens in Bard and see what it means for you. So first, you'll notice Bard can now produce images for you in a response, like we see here when I asked about the best Italian restaurants near me, and this Sydney to-do list as well. It's pulling these images from the web. So it could pull from Yelp or the restaurant's website or Wikipedia, TripAdvisor, just as a few examples. You get the idea. But that's not all when it comes to images in Bard. As I mentioned, Google Lens is now in Bard. So you can upload a photo as part of your prompt. To do so, click on the plus symbol to the left-hand side of the prompt bar. Here, you can click to upload a JPEG, PNG, or WebP. Then you can add a text prompt. So maybe I want to generate captions for this image. I'm not even gonna tell it or give it details on what the actual image is. I want Bard to do that. And it's going to be able to do that because of Google Lens. So, here we go, we've got three caption ideas. Now they aren't great, mind you, but my prompt was also pretty basic too, so you get the idea here. So you could do this with an image from the web if you wanted more information on it, but there are a couple of things to keep in mind when it comes to images in Bard, at least as of right now. First, This is currently only available in English, though we can expect it to roll out to more languages soon. Second, this does not work for images of people yet. So landscapes, pets, places, it's all good, but just not for photos containing humans. And third, Google Lens in Bard is not the same as having Bard create an AI-generated image. That will be coming with an Adobe Firefly Bard extension, but it's not quite ready yet. So to be clear, Google Lens is used to analyze an image, not create an AI-generated one. Hopefully that makes sense. By the way, I have a few other Bard videos listed for you in the description below, as well as videos on Bing Chat and ChatGPT, because, well, you can really never have too much AI content, can you? Thanks for jumping inside these new Bard features with me. What do you think of these Google Bard updates? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here for even more Google content. Thanks for watching. See you next time.